Yes, hello. Welcome back to Networking Lab. So, yeah, today's topic, I will talk about EIG or pre-routing protocol. As you already know that EIG or pre-routing protocol is the dynamic routing protocol. So, as you've seen in the diagram, I have six routers and I have loopback interfaces. Okay, I will use the GNS3 for implement this network, and I will use AS number 100. I'm using loopback addresses because I just want to represent the local networks. Okay, if you want to extend your switch from router 1 and switch from router 6 to your local network, it's you can follow as the loopback address. Okay, because I just don't want to create another PCs and another switch. Okay, just the represent of local network on router 1 and on router 6. Okay, let's start GNS3 software. Just wait. Okay, I need to create a project. Okay, I will call this project as the EIGRP routing. Okay, you can use any project name as you like. Okay, just represent your diagram. Okay, I use the EIGRP routing protocol. So, as you seen in diagram, I have six routers. Okay, so I just drag and drop for six routers. Oh, once again, as you seen this GNS3 software, automatically when you start the router and you go to console. Okay, any switches and router, whenever you start and you go to console, it will automatically bypass the enable. Okay, it's automatically bypass the enable. If you want to be able to use enable, okay, you need to do some configurations. Okay, so here you see you don't have to do you do you don't have to do to use the enable command. It's already enabled. Okay, so for me, I don't like this one, so I need to change this. Okay, so how I can change? So I can close this one. I need to remove the all routers. Okay, and I close the GNS3 because I will start it all again. So I go to Drive C on my user. I go to GNS3. I go to configs, and this one is for router. I can change this one to no privilege level 15, and line console also no privilege to level 15. Okay, then I save this one. I also had the Ethernet switch. Okay, I had installed Ethernet switch router, so this is the configuration. So you go down, yeah, you tap no privilege level 15, and No privilege, level 15. Then I save this one. Okay, then I restart the GNS3 again. Okay. Just wait. Then I can open the old project that I just created. I don't have to create a new project. So go to reason EIGRP. Okay, I go to router. Let's test. Okay, let's test start. And then we can use this to design our network. So I just want to test if it work or not. Okay, after we change the configuration. Here we go. It is working. So if you don't use enable, you won't be able to configure the router. So you have to use enable first. So this one is working. Okay. So let's start drag and drop for 6 routers. Okay, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, router 1 is here, 2 is here, I think 3 is here, right? 3, 4 and 4 up, 5 here, 6 here. Okay, so I just close this one so that I can have some space. Okay, 4, 3, right here, and 6. Okay, so let's connect it. Okay, G0/0 to G0/0 on router 2, as you see in the diagram. Okay. Router 2, router 3 is 1/0. Okay, 1/0. You can show the port label by clicking here. Okay, so I can have the correct label, especially the port. Yeah, you need to remember and then configure correctly. So this 3 to 4 0/0, 3 to 4 0/0, and 4 to 6 1/0. Six to 5 0/0, and 5 to 3 2/0. Okay, so let's make it nicely. Yeah. So we have 6 routers connected together, and we start assigning the address. Okay, this links is 1.1.1.0/, we can say /30 or /24, it's up to you. But normally normally private link, I mean the point-to-point link, normally we use /30. Yeah. Okay, we map the network 1.1.1.0/30. okay, so this interface will be .1. Okay, and this interface will be, so I can use it like this. This is the router 2. I can move here. So this will be number 2. Okay, and this will be 2/3. Okay, so this interface will be 2.2.2.1 And this one will be dot 2. Okay. This one will be, I move router 3 here so that I can write here. This one will be 3.3.3.2. And this one will be dot 1. And this one, router 4.2.6 is 6. Okay. You can use any address you like, but I just want to represent the router. Okay, 6.6.1. Okay, this one will be 6.2. Okay, dot 2. Link between 6 and 5. Okay. So I can use 5.5.5.2/30, and this one will be dot 1, and the last one is 4. Okay. The last one is 4. This one is 4.4.4.1, and this one is 2/0 on router 3 is dot 2. Okay, we have assigned the address for point-to-point links already between routers, so I need to assign the address of the loopbacks, okay, so that we can assign the address in the routers. Okay, I need to write here. Let's say loopback 192.168.1.0/24, and I have 3 in the addresses. Okay, dot 2 and dot 3. Okay, my local address, this one is my local address, and on my router 6 here I have 4 addresses: 200.1.1.0. Okay, let's say 200.1.1.0/24, right, dot 2/3/4. Okay, let me copy like this, only 2 octets. Okay, one, two, three, and 4. Sorry. One more. Dot 4.0/24. Yeah, we are done mapping the address, assign the address. So let's start. We start all routers. You can start all at once by clicking this one. Okay. So let me start from router 1. Okay. Right click, console. Please remember that we are using AS number 100. Okay. AS number 100. Okay, please remember this one. Let me put it bigger. Okay, we are using AS number 100. Okay, enable config t. We start assigning the address G0/0, int G0/0, IP address, sorry, no shut, IP address 1.1.1.1.255.255.255.252. Okay, and then I use loopback int loopback 1, sorry, wrong spelling, loopback 1, and IP address 192.168.1.1/24. Okay, then loopback 2, loopback 2, 2.1. Okay, and then loopback 3, loopback 3, 3.1. Okay, I have done configuration on interfaces, okay, and assigned the addresses already. So I start configure the routing. So as you already know that we are using EIGRP routing protocol. So to use EIG routing protocol, I forgot to change the size so that you can see better. To use EIG routing protocol, you go to config mode and you type router space EIGRP space AS number. Okay, AS number, then enter. So you can start advertise your network here from here, okay, by typing network. I would like to advertise my point-to-point links and also my local address, all my local address, okay, all my local address. So I start advertise 1.1.1.0 space 0.0.0.3. okay, because I'm using /30 wildcard is 0.0.0.3. okay, if you don't understand what is a wildcard, please refer to my previous video. Okay, then you can enter. So one more, as you know, this I have three networks. Okay, 1.0, 2.0, 3.0. I can either advertise each network, or I can use the subnetting or supernetting. Okay, if you want to advertise all at once, just alone, you can do a supernetting, okay? But I can use network one by one, okay? I can advertise one by one. 192.168.1.0/24 is 0.0.0.255 is wildcard subnet mask. Okay, so one more is .2, and also one more .3. Okay, the last is no auto summary. Okay. So I have done configuration of the routing protocol on router 1. For my configuration here, I just only config the routing. So some other basic like security, like you need to set the password for enable, password for like SSH, you can refer to my other videos, okay? Because here I just want to focus only on the routing protocol, okay? So let me just minimize this one. Before I minimize, I need to write the configuration because I'm afraid that I will lose all my configuration. You go to global mode and then you go to WO and then you enter to write all your configuration here. So, okay, so I just minimize this one, then I will come back to router 1 again later. So I go to router 2, okay? I go to router 2. I make it bigger so that it's better looks. 14. Okay, let's enter, then enable the same process. Okay, the same process. Config T. I need to assign the address of G0/0 INT G0/0 no shut. By default, all interfaces on router are shut down, so we need to give the command no shutdown so that the interface will turn up. Okay, so I assign the address 1.1.1.2/30, okay, /30252, okay, and then I go to interface of G1/0, okay, no shutdown, IP address 2.2.2.1/30, okay, 252, enter. Okay, I have done configuration the interfaces, so let's start the configuration of the routing protocol. It's like router 1, so we go to router EIGRP and then the AS number, okay. Then I just advertise my local network. Okay, I advertise 1.1.1.0/30. Wildcard 1.0.0.0.3. Okay, and my other one also. You see, it is form neighbor. Okay, because we already configured the router 1, so it's already formed as neighbor between router 2 and router 1. So I need to advertise another network 2.2.2.0, okay, wildcard. Then no auto summary. That's it for router 2. Then I write the configuration. You can check on router 1. It's also form a neighbor between router 1 and router 2, okay? My neighbor is 1.2. Where is 1.2? Here is 1.2. Yeah, this is my neighbor. Yeah. So it is form a neighbor between router 1 and router 2. So let's go to router 3. Okay, let's go to router 3. Mm-hmm. Okay, enter, enable, the same process, okay. But this router 3 has 3 interfaces, okay. It means also 3 networks. So we go to config terminal. We go to interface G1/0 is the interface linked to router 2. No shutdown. Then go to IP address 192. I'm sorry. 2.2.2.1.2. Okay. /30.252. And then we go to G0/0 is the interface linked to router 4. Okay, no shutdown. IP address 3.3.3.2/30. Okay, 252. And then we go to 2/0, which is linked to router 5. Linked to router 5. Okay, so let me go to interface G2/0. No shutdown. And then we assign the address. IP address. 4.4.4.2/30. Okay, no shutdown. Sorry, we already used the no shutdown. Yeah, we have done configure interfaces. Then we go to config mode. Then we assign the EIGRP AS number 100. Okay, AS number 100. Network. Let me do a network of 2, which link to router 2. So you can see the neighbor, okay, neighbor form. Okay, 0.0. My typing is not good. .3, okay. It will be form a neighbor to router 2, okay. You can see like this, it's already up, okay. So one more, I need to form a neighbor. I advertise my network 3.3.3.0 and also 4, okay. 4.4.4. Okay, and then no auto summary, and then I can write my configuration on router 3. You can check on router 2, it also form a neighbor between router 2 and router 3. This is the address which is its neighbor, router 2's neighbor. Okay. So we have done configuration of 3 routers. We have 3 router left, okay. So we can go to router 4. Go to router 4. Again, enable config terminal int G0/0, which is the link to router 3. Okay, IP address 3.3.3.1/30. Okay, sorry. Then we go to interface G1/0, which is linked to router 6. No shut. Then IP 6.6.6.1/30. Yeah, the same process. We go to router EIGRP 100. Then I advertise network of 3.3.3.0. 0.0.0.3 and then 6. It form neighbor between router 4 and router 3. Okay, so 6.6.6.0. Okay, and then no auto summary and WR. We have done configuration of router 4. Minimize, we go to router 5. Okay, we go to router 5. We almost done. Okay, router 5. Let me move here. Router 5, we have two interfaces. Okay, enable config terminal. INTG2/0. Okay, 2/0. No shut. IP address 4.4.4.1. 255.255.255.252. And then I go to interface G0/0. It's the link to router 6. Okay. No shut. IP address 5551. Okay, /30. Then start router EIGRP 100 network 4.4.4.0.0.0.0.3. Okay, it will be formed to router 4, sorry, router 3 from router 5. Okay, then another network is 5. Okay, 5.5.5.0. Then we can write the configuration. Minimize. The last router is router 6. Okay. The last router now. Okay. This router, we have more networks. Enable config terminal. And I need to go to interface G1/0. No shutdown. And then I add address, IP address. 6.6.6.2 255.255.255.252. Sorry, my mistake here. Okay, then I go to G0/0, which link to router 5. Address is 5.5.5.2 255.255.255.252. Okay, and then we start assign IP to loopback, INT loopback 1. Okay, loopback 1, IP address. Whenever you just go to loopback interface, it already automatically turn up. Okay, you no need to go. You no need to give the command no shutdown. It's automatically change to up. Okay. So I add address 200.1.1.1/24. Okay. And then the loopback two address 2. Loopback 3 address 3. Okay. You can just move the arrow key up. You no need to tap again. 4 IP is 4. Okay. Done configuration addresses. Then we go to routing protocol. Router EIGRP 100. Okay. Then we advertise the network. 6 and 5 first. 6.6.6.0, 0.0.0.3. It will be formed 2 router 4. This one will be formed 2 router 5. Okay. And we advertise our own network. Okay, we can advertise our own network. 200.1.1.0.0.0.0.255 is the wildcard for /24. If you don't want to advertise any of your local, no need to enter here. Okay, but for my exercise, I will advertise all networks. Okay, I will advertise all networks. Okay. 2, 3, 4. I advertise all networks. Okay, all my local networks. So we are done. Let's write our configuration. So to verify, I will ping to 192.168.1.1. It is working or not? Yes, it is working. So I can ping from router 6 to this loopback address, because router 1 already advertised the address. So I can ping from router 6 to router 1 local address. So let me show the routing table. So IP route. So I can see this is the D. What is the D mean? D is mean EIGRP. So I have used EIGRP routing protocol. So I can reach 192.168.1.0.2.0 and .3.0. I can reach. Okay, I can reach to the local address in router 1. 1.0, I can reach to two ways. Okay, one is I can reach from router 4. Another one, I can reach through router 5. That's why you can see these two ways, two links. I can reach either through router 4 or through router 5. Okay, this is the simulation of redundancy links. If this link is down, the router 6 still reach router 1 through this router 5, through these links. Okay, let's see router 1. routing table, where is router 1, yes. And I can ping test to 200.1.1.1. It's also success. Okay, it's also success. So let me show IP route. I also can reach the 200. Okay, I also can reach the 200. But this router 1, I can have only one next hop. My next hop is only 1.1.1.2. I don't have two links like router 6. My router 6, I have two links. This is my next hop address and also my next hop address to link to reach this network. Okay. So, but router 1, I have only one link to router 2. So, whenever I want to go outside the network, I need to access the go through router 2. And this is the address of my next hop from router 1. Okay, so this is how you go to configure EIGRP routing protocol. So any other routing protocol is similar because it's all dynamic routing protocol. You can use the command router, and then you can replace by from EIGRP, you can replace by OIP, or you can replace by OSPF, but all are the same. Okay, I think that's all for my exercise. So if you have any doubt and any comment, just type below the video so that I can answer your questions. Okay, and thank you for watching.